The poll question is which one of the stars, I don't know if you were able to hear the recounting of which one of the ringless stars whose career you'd rather have. If you read them the poll question one more time here, Chris.
Yeah, running down Charles Barkley, Patrick Ewing, Karl Malone, Steve Nash, John Stockton.
What do you think, Greg?
Does that include the totality of their career post-basketball?
No, I think it's just them basketball. Good question, Greg. Good question.
Well,
no.
That might change it. I'd probably still go Barkley.
Hmm. Why was that then?
I think Malone has had an incredible career. I think those are the two guys that are of the four, the best players. And I think, you know, those two guys were in the conversation as best player in the league. The other two weren't, and that's no slight on them. They were obviously tremendous players. But also, I probably would have liked playing in Phoenix and Houston because they got great golf.
Nice.
In the winter.
Yeah.
Okay. Philly, I would have had a chance to play with Dr. J, which would have been pretty cool. Moses Malone.
Okay. So that's you got to factor all that in.
Yeah, you do, you know. And I think he was the more marketable star of all four. And so I would probably go that route. Obviously he got to play in the finals, didn't win it, but he did make it. So I would probably go with the Chuckster.
Okay, very good. What'd you think of the Charles Shaq back and forth on TNT last night, Greg?
I loved it. I was retweeting it this morning.
Mm-hmm.
The irony of it is, in a weird way, they both kind of were right. You know, I don't know that, I'm not as concerned with DeRozan not playing in that fourth quarter because we've seen that happen on many occasions with great players because it wasn't going well and the group guys they put out there ended up getting the job done. All you got to do is go back a few years ago with Chris Paul and the Clippers were playing Houston. James Harden got benched.
Mm-hmm.
In the closeout game when it was 3-1, he didn't play in that fourth quarter. They were down, 16, 17. They come back, they win that game, they go on to win the series. So, you know, that stuff happens. Scottie Pippen got benched, I recall, when we played him when I was with the Knicks.
Well, was that the game he didn't come off the bench, Greg? Is that the game where he refused to come back off the bench?
Yeah, exactly.
What were you guys thinking about? Because obviously Rodney Hood is a similar case, although it was a blowout. He wouldn't go in the game. But
and it's not, you know, it's not as big a deal as it will be made out to be in the world we live in today because that stuff actually happens a lot. And it's more about you being a professional and owning up to it, apologizing for it, which he did. The coach ain't going to take that personal. The kid's, you know, world been turned upside down, comes in a new situation, hasn't gone well, struggling with his confidence, you know. And from what I understand, it wasn't malicious. He just basically said, hey, why don't you just let the other guys play? Now, again, I don't know verbatim, but that's what I was told. It's a non-issue, you know, and in some ways this might help him in terms of trying to get his feel. I mean, this stuff, people don't understand how hard it is to go from one team to another. I remember Derek Harper did that. He came from the Mavericks to the Knicks. And when I tell you, he was a shell of himself for about 2 months. I mean, he had no confidence. And this is a guy who had been a multiple all-star, had played on one of the best teams in the league with the Mavericks, with Rolando Blackman. And it just took him a while to kind of get comfortable. But once he did, he just took off and got back to being a player that he had been over the course of his career. So it could be a similar dynamic with Rodney Hood. It's just tough when you're coming into a new situation, new role, new terminology, new city, new expectations, all that stuff, man. It does affect different people differently. And I feel for Rodney Hood. I think eventually he's going to figure out who he is within that environment and hopefully things work out.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on Audience.